tequila, patron!
Fabio Quartararo is the 2021 World Champion!
World Champion, baby!
Look, I want to win the championship in Misano. But that stayed a few minutes. I said, oh, keep calm because it's going to be tough. But I'm still saying that for me was, okay, not a normal Grand Prix, but I wanted to take it like a normal Grand Prix.
I ask everyone around to act the same as normal. In the garage, everything was the same, and we make like a normal weekend.
C'est très important pour nous de pas faire d'erreurs si on peut aller la gagner.
From tomorrow we're starting like a normal weekend.
These two that are fighting for the championship, they have been consistently the best two riders on the grid this year. Pekka Bagnaia, four podiums in the last five races, and he's really built some great momentum.
For me, the only thing that I can do is win, to try to stay in the fighting for the championship.
We need to plan it like the beginning of the year, and then on Sunday we will see the amount of risk that we will take.
Welcome back to Misano. It's the Grand Prix of Emilia-Romagna, three left in the 2021 season, and it's a drizzly start to proceedings. There would have been a number of riders last night hoping that we would have had a dry start to this morning.
World Championship leader Fabio Quartararo is there in 16th place and struggling in the wet and drying conditions.
This man's hoping for a trouble-free weekend. Fabio Quartararo can win the World Championship here tomorrow. 52-point lead, but this is not the weather he wanted to wake up to.
8-9 lap time. Qui se la shock usata da dietro non si piace, che non tiene grip come ieri, andiamo sulla media.
Three rounds to go in the World Championship, and this weekend match point. The moment for Fabio has finally arrived. Everyone's really making steps forward here. Quartararo not going to be far off the top 10 with this lap. Here comes the World Championship leader across the line, and he goes to 10. He's going to need a bit more though.
This man clearly has got some work to do. He's not been a frequent visitor at all since he joined MotoGP in 29 in Q1 sessions. Fabio Quartararo then, he's only T13.
What I'm missing a little bit in the fast corner, to really have the edge grip to turn a little bit more.
He was not relaxed on the bike. He was not comfortable as he was used to be.
Diego, I struggled to warm up the tire.
He was too conservative, a bit too much.
Like in the other one, it's dry and I can push hard. I can't because the bike is so aggressive and the tire are cold.
Is this lap going to be enough to clinch a provisional place at the moment in Q2? Over the line he comes. It's not. It's 11th. It's an improvement. It's his best time of the weekend. Quartararo will have to go through Q1. Fabio Quartararo, a rare appearance in Q1, and he knows it's imperative that he finds a way into that top two. That will not be an easy task.
Fabio Quartararo. Surely he's going to be putting him inside that top two, top three. Potentially he's gone top. That's the best lap we've seen of the weekend so far. Bagnaia and Quartararo are on stunning laps. Bagnaia is about to blast his way to P1 and top spot. He goes fastest. Second will go to Alex Marquez. But look out for Fabio Quartararo. Will he take second place? He does! Brilliant! By Quartararo.
Oh, Rins has pinched it and there's a crash! Rins has pinched it and there's a crash into sector one and two. And that might be it. It's gone.
Fabio Quartararo for the first time in 2021 will not go through to Q2.
I didn't feel any grip.
And yeah, I couldn't make any step, you know.
Oh, putain.
I was not happy about the result, but happy about what he did in the wet. So was mixed feeling, but let's say I was quite happy. And I say to the team, look, we start the weekend at 3 seconds, we finish at 0.8 on the wet, so. I took out some pressure because I start from 15th and Pecco from first. So I say, look, the title change will not be here.
Today, it's match point Fabio Quartararo. We could be crowning a MotoGP world champion. A Frenchman to create history. 1949, we had the first Grand Prix World Championship in Premier Class history. There's never been a Frenchman that's taken the prize.
He texts me in the morning, I wake up before. Normally, he always wake up before me. And this day, I wake up before and I go to the hospitality. And he sent me a message like, it's raining.
Because, you know, I didn't want it to have a wet race.
Because he hears some noise, say, I sent the picture like was full blue.
He just sent me the picture of a clear sky and I was like, whew, like good. At that moment I had only one thing in my mind and was the race. You are playing for your dream. Your dream can be realized in a few hours or not. To have them with me was the first things I wanted to have.
Tranquille.
Allez, m'en fiche.
Before the race, we said, okay, we try to have the same approach of every weekend before this one. Forget about the title, try to have a smart weekend, and that's it.
Try pin for the goma davanti di scattare. Okay. Quando la senti pronta, in quei punti lì puoi attaccare. Prima magari attacca in altri punti se devi attaccare.
Okay.
Pekka Bagnaia, as always, looking impervious to pressure. Ice cool, and he needs to be, because this is a big race. Pekka Bagnaia on pole for the fourth time on the trot. With Fabio Quartararo starting way back in 15th. What's in store today? It's match point Fabio Quartararo. He could become world champion here today.
Still right now, I'm imagining myself there and I start to feel nervous. In the grid, I had so much pain. Like I had a tangle on my stomach. I think I have even headache before to start. Diego told me something that was super funny.
Si sente il nodo, eh?
Lo sai che appena parte dopo il nodo va via.
Le job tu l'as fait avant. C'était toute la saison. Il en reste une course comme il en reste deux et puis voilà.
I tell him enjoy. Now you have a lot of points. Enjoy, everything will be okay.
Is this the day of destiny for Fabio Quartararo? There are three races left in MotoGP 2021. This is the 16th chapter of the year. We're ready to go racing in MotoGP. Eyes on the lights and away we go. Oh, Quartararo is getting beaten up on the early stages already. He's been bulked through the first couple of corners. In the end of lap one then, it's the Ducati 1-2, Bagnaia and Miller.
The first lap that Pecco Bagnaia wanted.
I came from 15th, first corner was 17th.
It's not been the start that Fabio Quartararo needed. He's lost two places straight away, out of the points, 15th to 17th for the World Championship leader. A big, big race in terms of the MotoGP World Championship destiny. Quartararo is through on Zarco. Miller's down, Miller's gone. Oh dear, Jack Miller has gone down at turn 15. Further back, Quartararo's got through on Lecuona. The Frenchman now into the top 10. Yeah, Quartararo though just wants to make sure each move is clean. Bagnaia versus Marquez, 0.347, the advantage for the Italian over the line. Fabio Quartararo immediately, having got through on Marini and Morbidelli, is able to gap that pair back at the front. Quartararo through the fast right-handers. Well, he said he wasn't going to take too many risks in this crucial Misano Grand Prix. He's taking big, big risks, and we love to see it. Brilliant by Fabio Quartararo.
Then happened what happened.
Pecco Bagnaia has crashed out while leading and he's consoled by senior Ducati management, but it's over.
Devo far così, cioè l'unico modo era questo, lo sprint, ma se uno deve credere niente, tutto potrà ricordare un capolavoro. Mi dispiace solo essere caduto un'altra volta così. Sono quelle volte che cadi che non capisci perché, è quello che fa veramente incazzare.
In a fraction of second I look straight and I saw red bike on the gravel and I say, Jack just crashed in the first laps, so is Pecco. And I look back the TV again, say, okay, now I'm world champion. And I didn't know how to ride, and to be honest, the last four laps, I was not focused at all. I was riding and just looking at L3, lap three to go, two to go, one to go, and I was like, come on, check red flag, please. And Bastianini overtook me and I said, okay, I don't care. When you cross the finish line, you saw all the, more than the good moments, you see all the bad moments that you had in the past, and now you cross the finish line and as soon as you cross, you know that you are world champion. So it's amazing feeling.
Back down, I don't need no help. Switch like a free throw, breaking out the beast mode. Walking with the Pico, when it goes down, I'm up, no cheat codes, yeah. Just doing what I gotta do. Take it to the top, no attitude. Cause I give it everything, punch my tears if you hate, I ain't mad at you.
And then was this amazing celebration. And yeah, it's a moment that I will never forget. I think that celebration, I saw it 50 times, and yeah, it will stay for forever.
What a great shot that is. Pecco Bagnaia, having just lost the MotoGP World Championship. One of the first men in pit lane to come and congratulate the newly crowned world champion.
In 2016, my mom especially was crying, but in a bad way, you know that. Now we cry because we are going well. So if I'm here today, it's because they were here to help me when I was a child.
Having the party with the people I love the more, that my family, friends, my team, that I consider everybody like family. For me, it was the best moment. These 15 hours after the checkered flag were just amazing. So having a French rider world champion, I think also it brings a lot of spectators and new fans to the world. And what is sure, I will be the first one for forever.